I am the former chair of Oak Park's Historic Preservation Commission, and I've been active in the Frank Lloyd Wright Preservation Trust, which oversees his home and studio here in Oak Park, with Landmarks Illinois, the state preservation advocacy. And I'm a frequent speaker and lecturer on preservation architectural topics in the Chicago area and in the state of Illinois. And, you know, it's been a passion. Preservation came to me as a combination of my passion between architecture and history. And it's always been something that I love, that an historic building has a story to it, and a neighborhood has a story to it that can't be replicated with new construction. Not that there's anything wrong with new buildings and great architecture, no matter it's when it's built, and eventually it'll have a story that it can tell. But to lose what we have built upon loses something about our history and our culture that we don't want to completely get rid of. Preservation preservation of architecture preserves the fabric of our community and the history and our culture, but it also has an economic side to it. Preservation brings an economic value by stabilizing and even increasing property values. Many studies have shown that it has done that in communities that have embraced preservation. And by reusing an historic building, you are saving both the demolition costs, but also the waste of demolition. And this is especially important with our desire in today's world to be more sustainable and to be less wasteful. And by reusing and recycling buildings, we bring value to the architecture that already exists. And there's an inherent quality in a historic building in its craftsmanship, its materials, and its construction that is extremely difficult and sometimes impossible to replicate in a new construction unless you have large amounts of money to invest in it. And, you know, we have buildings that are 80, 100, 150 years old that are still standing and still useful and can continue to be so for the indefinite future. Can't always be said of buildings that are 20, 30, even 50 years old. Village of Downers Grove has been making efforts to address preservation planning for several years, since the early 2000s. And one effort of that started in 2013 to conduct what we call an architectural survey in different neighborhoods of the village that are core concentrations of some of its historic buildings, including the Maple Avenue corridor, the Prince subdivision, Denburn Woods, or several of the more prominent examples. And a team was put together, spearheaded by the Lakota Group, a planning firm in Chicago, and I was a part of that team as a consultant to them. And what it involved is looking at all of the buildings in these specific neighborhoods and evaluating their architectural character and what we call integrity, whether they've been changed or altered over time, and rating them as to whether a property was historically or architecturally significant or not at all or somewhere in between. And that just helps to provide the village with an overall planning document to help them determine what buildings are important to preserve and encourage to preserve and which ones are not. Well, the Edwards House was listed as significant, as an architecturally significant property in the village, and especially along the Maple Avenue corridor. And it was done so because it's what we would call a high style of Queen Anne architecture. It has much more elaborate materials and features and elements that are typical of the Queen Anne style of architecture. And it also has what we call integrity, which means that the building hasn't been significantly altered that changes its historic appearance. In the entire village, we surveyed around 900 properties in these different neighborhoods. And of those, only about 7.5% were listed as significant. So it's a very small number or percentage of buildings that rise to that level, either architecturally, perhaps historically, or in association with an important person in Downers Grove history. In the case of the Edwards House, it was because of its architecture. And it is so good, what we call high style, so many elements and features to it that is very unusual, even in a Queen Anne style home, which is usually quite elaborate home. There were a number along Maple Avenue. Many of those were Queen Anne homes, but interestingly, the Edwards House actually is probably one of the best Queen Anne style homes along Maple Avenue. And that's because it has more of the typical features and elements that characterize the style than most of the other homes have. And so again, it's what we classify as high style versus a more vernacular or simpler builder type of Queen Anne home. You know, I think it's important to make the effort to save this house. It is one of the finest homes in Downers Grove and certainly along the Maple Avenue corridor. And Maple Avenue is really one of your most historic neighborhoods in Downers Grove. It was the center of residence for many of the upper crust of early Downers Grove. Of course, the Blodgett family was one of the most prominent there. And to preserve the house preserves that connection to early Downers Grove history. But it also has other benefits to the community. It preserves a large, well-built, important home that can easily be reused and recycled for the future. It helps to stabilize and even improve upon property values. It's going to replace a more modest home on a large property, and so it will help to benefit everybody's property values in that neighborhood by keeping that sense of history and character that so many people like, both the homeowners that live there, but also people that pass through and generate their impressions of Downers Grove by driving down Maple Avenue.